Okay, so let's move on to the next demo. I'll go ahead and check this in. And let's create another new table. Except this time we're going to do a link. So instead of calling this table from SQL, let's call this table in SQL. Or maybe even just to make it real obvious, table still in SQL. What we're saying, what the point I'm trying to make here is that this is data that's going to be linked to a SQL Server table that's not going to be affected by whatever I do over here with it. I've just got a read-only access to this. So data from SQL is the data that, hey, I got it in here, now I can do anything I want with it. This is more of a link, or this is a link, so in this case I'm simply going to be retrieving it. Now the beauty of this is that it's only being retrieved when it's required by an AF client. So it's only when an AF client is going to be looking at some of the attributes that make use of this table that will actually involve the link to the SQL table. And in our subsequent videos, we're going to take a look at how we would actually make use of this tabular data as the attributes that we show in an element. So we'll make use of this in just a few minutes. But right now, let's just concentrate on getting this data in, and we'll concentrate on using it later on. So to bring this in as a linked table, I'll choose this link option. And as you can see, we've actually picked up some of the credentials that we used before. That's only kind of, it's been kind of cached locally since we just recently made this retrieval. So if you're doing this for the first time, you're very likely not to see that. So in fact, why don't we do this? Let me check this in. I don't want to do any cheating here by having some nice credentials all cached waiting for us. I just exited out of the Pi System Explorer and I'm going to load it back up again. We should not see that cached data now when I choose link. Let's choose link. As you can see, this is more likely what you would typically see. You know, there's no cached credentials already sitting there waiting for us to exploit. So, you know, here's the previous table we did. Now let's do the new one that's going to be a link. For a link, we'll do that same retrieval of the connection string that we did before. I'll specify OLEDB provider for SQL. I'll go ahead and choose the right one. That's the right instance of SQL. I'm going to choose NT integration, and we'll choose the database. That's material ID. Test the connection. That looks good. Okay. Now, how do we specify the query? Well, it's the same query that we did before. So there's really nothing new here. Actually, let's make this a little bit more interesting. I'll add a couple more. Let's add viscosity and melting temperature. Density, viscosity, and in double quotes, let's look at melting temperature from material properties. And we're just about ready to finish. Except we've got this one last hurdle here, and boy, it is a big hurdle, security. You know what? We have written so much about this issue, how to set this up and what your choices are, that I don't even want to attempt to do it in this. I mean, this is one of those times where in this class, and typically when you come to one of our regular classes, we simply do not go into the detail required to go over all the different permutations here, because it's an enormous topic. We don't do it justice in our classes or in these CBTs because, to be honest, this is one of those things you only do it once generally, you know, when you first configure the system. And if you're a SQL professional, you know, an IT professional that's been working with SQL, you certainly don't need to hear what we're going to say in a short class on this topic. And if you're not, this is something that we can easily help you with on technical support. We've got it documented fairly well. We've also got, in addition to the documentation, we've got hundreds of technical support calls from people with all different kinds of configurations, some using Kerberos for security, some using, you know, going across domains, you know, some using different versions of Windows. You know, you can imagine the permutations are huge, so we don't attempt to try to teach it here. Let me actually show you what we can show you that we think is useful in the context of a user class. So let's go ahead and I'll go ahead and acknowledge. And what we should see now is, there we go, our retrieval's working. It brought in those values that we needed before. And if I go ahead and check this in, you know, what you'll notice now It's the same data. The only difference, of course, is the data that we see right here. This is data that we've copied into AF. This is data that's linked. And this is going to be something that's a read-only. So as you can see, I cannot go in. I cannot double-click on this and start editing, which is something that I could easily do. If you remember, I could easily do that over here because that's my own local copy. So the issue with security is really one of how you're going to be making this connection. If you recall, when we did this link here, we had three different options. Okay? And that's what I'd like to address here. What do these three different options mean, and where you would find more information about these? So when we specify no additional security context, which is the one that seems to be most prominently mentioned throughout our documentation, and I assume is the one that most of you will be using, then what this simply means is that we're going to use the regular credentials of the AF server to connect to SQL Server, in this case, and retrieve that data from the linked table. Now, Impersonate Client is an option that will allow the AF client that's running is actually going to, you know, that we're going to get the credentials from that AF client. The AF server will be connecting to SQL Server but impersonating that AF client. And then supply password, we don't specifically put it here, but this is what we're going to be passing as if you're using SQL Server credentials. So if you decide to use SQL Server credentials, you're going to be using this option right here. Well, where would you find out more information about all of these? Thankfully, we've got a very good section in the AF User's Guide that explains exactly what you're going to be expected to do on the server side if you're choosing any of those three. So it's the section called Importing or Linking. It's currently on page 204 in the User's Guide. And you'll notice that we define those three, or we make reference to those three different instances here. So we say when linking, if you're using integrated security with no additional security context, that was the first option, then we specify some things to do. If you're using SQL Server authentication, then we specify some other things. If we're choosing impersonation, there's some other things. All of these things are referenced in great detail if you look at this section here on making this link. So for example, there are three things to look for here. If you're using the integrated security, and if you're specifying the impersonate client option, then here's the specifics that we're suggesting that you do. Okay? There's a section on page 208 on configuring security on the target database, and then actually doing the linkings described on 210. If you're using the integrated security and you've got the no additional security option, then you need to do it this way. And as you go through this, you'll see, yeah, here's the third one. If you're using SQL Server security, then we suggest you go about it this way. Now, a second place you can go is there's a section. It begins on page 304 in that same document. And you'll find all the security considerations to keep in mind as you're configuring this. And as you can see, there are a wealth of recommendations here on how to make sure that your security configuration is truly secure. Okay, so in summary, when you're trying to either import or link to a table that's in a relational database that's OLEDB compliant, you know, when it comes to the actual configuration, we do suggest that you get involved with whoever your local SQL experts are so that you can, you know, make the right connections, make the right queries, and more importantly, have the right security settings that are going to work in your environment. And if you need help with the security configuration, please take a look in our AF User's Guide. There's a section on importing or linking SQL Server data. Also look at the additional recommendations we have for server security. And if you still need help, please contact our technical support group.